अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम टू द क्लास ऑफ फाइनेंशियल अकाउंटिंग। वी हैव डन क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 एंड टुडेज आवर टॉपिक इज अबाउट क्वेश्चन नंबर 8। टॉपिक इज डिपार्टमेंटल अकाउंटिंग चैप्टर नंबर 1 फॉर BS 8 मॉडर्न अकाउंटेंसी और स्पेशलाइज्ड अकाउंटिंग एंड द क्वेश्चन इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 8। होप सो ऑल ऑफ यू आर फाइन and ready for this chapter, your mind will be agree with this chapter. So now we move towards the question number 8. Move towards the page number 1.41, page number 1.41, exercise number 8, chapter number 1, Hanif and Mukherjee, मॉडर्न अकाउंटेंसी बुक हनीफ एंड मुखर्जी। द क्वेश्चन इज द ट्रेडिंग एंड प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट ऑफ हिंदुस्तान इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स फॉर द ईयर एंडे March 31, 2001 इज एज अंडर। ट्रेडिंग एंड प्रॉफिट लॉस अकाउंट फॉर हिंदुस्तान इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स आर गिवन, बट इन दिस क्वेश्चन यू विल फाइंड देयर विल बी 3 डिपार्टमेंट्स, डिपार्टमेंट एक्स, डिपार्टमेंट वाई एंड डिपार्टमेंट Z. Department X deals in transistors, they buy and sell transistors. Department Y deals in tape recorders, while Department Z deals in spare parts. These are their specific departments. And the question you will find, the purchases will be given for transistor, tape recorders, spare parts. But the problem is that the expenses which are wages, rent and sundry expenses are given for these three department in a combined form. You can't know that what will be the amount for department X, what will be the amount for department Y, and what will be amount for department Z. This is the main point in this question. In this question, nothing is new but the distribution of expense. In the credit side, you will find the sales for these three departments and stock for these three departments. And after this, there are some specific informations are available. But we will discuss this information with the solution when we are going to solve the question. We will discuss these points at that time. Now move towards the solution. And at the solution, we are going to prepare trading and profit and loss account. In trading and accounting profit and loss account, the first column is about particulars, then for department X, then for department Y, and then for department Z. The total, and they come to the credit side, particulars, department X, Y, Z, and total. You will write the purchases as 8 for department X, Y, Z, and combine and make it a total 3,65,000. Sales on the credit side for department XYZ and closing stock for department XYZ on the credit side, because we are preparing trading account. So sales and closing stock are always come on the credit side and purchases come on the debit side. The most important point is the wages, rent and salary expense. How we will distribute the wages? As you can see in the question, purchases is available for department A, B and C, as we have discussed. The same thing is available for sale and closing stock. But the problem is about wages, rent and sundry data expense. Wages is 10,800. So how we will distribute it? Come to these points. Prepare departmental account for each of three department X, Y, Z mentioned above after taking into consideration the following. A. Transistor and tape recorder are sold at the showroom. Transistors and tape recorders are sold at the showroom means the department X and department Y. Their transistors, which one department deals in transistor? Department A. Tape recorder, which one department deals in tape recorder? Department B. So why? Department X and Y are comes under the heading of showroom. Why they are mentioning you? Because there are some purpose behind this sentence. What is that purpose? Purpose is transistors and tape recorders are sold in showroom. Transistors and tape recorders sold in showroom means department X and Y come under the heading of showroom. Service and repair are carried out at workshop. So department Z come under the heading of workshop. Now they have given you information. Wages comprises showroom 3x4 and workshop 1x4. They are giving you the information that wages will be distributed for department XY 3x4 and department Z 1x4. Details of calculations working. In working, the first thing is department X is transistors, department Y is tape recorders, and department Z is spare parts. And transistors and tape recorders are recorded on showroom, while spare parts come under workshop. So, what is the wages expense? 48,000. And the 48,000, 3x4 is for workshop and 1x4 is for showroom. So, you can see that this is for workshop and this is for showroom and this for workshop. We have distributed N above. After that, you can see in the question that it was decided to allocate the showroom wages because the problem is about showroom wages. In workshop wages, there is only wages of department Z, but in the 3x4, the expenses which is given to the portion of showroom, it's include department X and department Y. ये कहना चाहते हैं कि wages जो है उसमें से 3x4 showroom का है और 1x4 workshop का है. जो 3x4 showroom का है तो showroom में department X भी आता है और department Y भी आता है. जब दो departments आते हैं तो अब इसमें हमें नहीं पता कि 3x4 की 4 की जो amount आ रही है इसमें से X का कितना है portion है और Y का कितना portion है. तो इन्होंने information दी है ratio of 1x2 between department X and department Y respectively. So we will distribute wages, which one? 36,000 as a ratio of 1 and 2. You can see 36,000 into 1 by 3, 12,000, 36,000, 2 by 3, 24,000. Now the problem is solved. Wages is distributed and you can see wages 12,000, 24,000 and 12,000 respectively. The next issue is about rent. You can see the workshop rent is 500 per month. Workshop rent is 500 per month. So what will be the amount for per annum, full year? 500 multiplied 12, you will get 6,000. Distribution of rent. 500 into 12 is equal to 6,000. How much is the amount of rent? Amount of rent is, you can see, 10,800. These amounts are basically get up and down by me in typing. Rent expense is 10,800 and in 10,800, 6,000 is given to the department. Now remaining is 44,800. What will be available in the question? The workshop rent is 500 and which one department is a workshop? Department Z. Department Z have 6,000 rent. What will be ref for department X and Y? The rent of showroom is to be divided equally between department X and Y respectively. So we will distribute it equally, the remaining 4,800 between department X and department Y, and the problem you can see easily solved. Rent 2,400, 2,400 and 6,000 respectively. The next is salary expense. You can see salary expense are to be allocated on the basis of the turnover of each department. What's mean by turnover? Sales. You have to make the ratio from sales 1,75,000, 1,40,000, 35,000. Simply you have to make its ratio and you will get 5x10, 4x10 and 1x10, and you will distribute the selling expense accordingly between department X, Y and Z. Now nothing is left, problem is solved. You can easily calculate, add sales plus closing stock, deduct purchases, wages, rent and salary expense. You will get profit for department X. The same you will do for department Y, 1,14,000 plus 20,300, deduct purchases, wages, rent, salary expense and you will get the profit. And you same you will do for department Z and total, which I have didn't do calculation for you people. I left this item for you people. And after the calculation of these balances, you will make a total for debit side and for credit side as well. The both sided will comes equal. I hope this question was so much easy. Nothing important in this question, just about the problem is about the calculation distribution of these three expense. I hope The problem will be clear to all of you. If there are still any problem, any query, you can ask in the comment section. Thank you so much for being with me, for learning about these expenses. Take care. Allah Hafiz.